Hi, this is JP from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time I will be playing my first game with the new hero Gamora. I will be playing against the Brotherhood of Badoon in a standalone setting, so no campaign additions and in standard difficulty. I will be using the pre-built deck that comes with Gamora's hero pack, so let's get started. So I just got the Gamora hero pack sleeved up and ready to go. Gamora comes with an aggression pre-built deck, but her ability to include extra events from attack and ward events from other aspects is also present, so the deck also includes three cards from Justice and three cards from the Protection, so mainly aggression but also some attack and ward events from other aspects. We are, as I said, playing Brotherhood of Badoon on standard difficulty. I already set up the scenario and ready to draw our opening hand. So I'll draw six. So we get set the pace, clobber, first hit, genius, drugs, plan of attack. So I think we don't need to, let's think about it, we could clobber, so that returns into our hand, then we can set the pace. We could use the clobber to play first hit, but we also would like to get Drax into play. So maybe we keep Drax, we forget the clobber, and we'll do this. Okay, I think I'm keeping the whole hand. Oh yeah, I have the Milano, so I could play plan of action. Okay, so I'm using the action to look at the top card of my deck. It is an attack event, so I'll take it into hand. Now we have a decisive blow also. Okay, this changes the turn a bit. So we could... let's see. Set the pace is a ward, so we can play that. Then we, yeah, we'll definitely play the decisive blow. Okay, this is starting to look pretty good. So we'll flip to hero mode. We'll play Drax. I'll use the clobber and genius, and Drax hits for 3 damage, and Drax can only hit the villain because Drax can't attack minions. So 3 damage. I think this could be a really quick game, but well, it is what it is. We'll play the plan of attack. So we should have done this in Alter Ego. Well, I'll grab the uppercut because we are just using that as a resource, so we can just get rid of that. And we'll play the set the pace. We'll remove one threat from a scheme, and then we deal 1 damage. Gamora's ability. Then I'll use the first hit and uppercut to play decisive blow. So we deal 7 damage because we already played a thwart event this turn. So 7 damage here. And we'll use the finesse to remove one threat. And we even didn't even need the Milan this turn. Okay. Actually, let's use the Milan and save the first hit for the villain phase. Okay, and Gamora will hit for 2, so we'll advance to phase 2. So that was a really quick phase 1 rank. So, when revealed, if Drang Spear is in play, give Drang one face down boost card. Otherwise, search the encounter deck and discard for Drang Spear. Reveal it and shuffle the encounter deck. So, let's do that next. So, we'll search for the spear. Okay, so it was near the top of the deck. So, Drang gets the spear, so now Drang has Stalwart, and I'll use this what are you doing counter that I just got to represent that Drang can't be stunned or confused. And then I think that is our hero phase. We'll just add the health Drang. Okay, so we're ready up. We have a hand size of 5, so 4 cards. We'll keep the first hit for the villain phase. If we happen to get the minion for some reason. So we have another plan of attack. God Slayer, Clubber, hit and run. First hit. We add 2 threat to the main scheme. Then we'll add charge counter here. Drang attacks, Gamora will take the attack. I won't defend, so 4 plus 2 is 6. So a pretty hard hit right away. Encounter card for this turn is Badoon Sentry. Retaliate 1, 5 health. Okay, and that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see what we can do this turn. So we really need to get rid of the Badoon Sentry somehow. It has 5 health. And also retaliate 1. So I think I will be doing something with Gamora, then going back to Alter Ego. To heal. So first up, Drax will just hit Drang for 3 damage. Then I will play the Clubber. I'll use the God Slayer and plan attack. I'll deal 3 damage to an enemy. And this is the first card I'm playing this turn, so I'll return it back to my hand. I'll deal 3 damage here. And this guy retaliates for 1. Then I will hit and run. So I'll use this and Milan. Oh yeah, and I removed 1 from here. So I'll hit and run. I'll deal 2 damage to an enemy. And remove 2 threat. And I'll also deal 1 damage with my precision. And then I'll hit. No, I'll go and heal for 3 because I think we're getting some Badoon ship bombardment this round. So we'll heal. We're ready up. and we'll draw back up to 6. We get Nebula, Angela, Impede, Gamora Sword, Combat Training and Impede. Okay, well, pretty good hand for next gen. Okay, and we go to the villain phase. We add 2 threat here. This charges up. Drang will scheme for 2 plus. It's not an attack activation, so this doesn't do anything. So, 2 threat here. And 1 counter here. So, when we hit 4, this will deal 2 indirect damage. We're at 3. Okay, and encounter card for this turn is blockade. Okay, so blockade is 2 plus hinder 2 per player, so 4. And it is a crisis icon, so we have to deal with that. And we can remove threat from there with Milan. That's okay. Well, that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. I think I'm starting by healing with Gamora, or actually I'm using the action to look at the top card. If it's an attack or sword, I'll take it in hand. It is not. And I'll just place it back because it doesn't say to shuffle it. So if I can draw a card somehow, I know it's double resource, but I don't see a way to do that. We could play more allies. I think that's our turn. Play one of those. So this and Milan. Or actually, I'm not needing the combat training this game. And we have enough for. Yeah, we could. No. Do we just play the Gamora sword? Choices. We need to deal 10 damage to win, so let's see if we can do that. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so yeah, let's just win the game this round. So I'll use both of the impedes to play combat training. I have a +1 attack, and I'll use Gamora sword and Milan to play Nebula, and I'll search for a card. I'll take the acrobatic move because I can search my deck for an attack. Yeah. And now I don't have to risk playing Angela to draw a guard minion. So I won't play Angela. And we'll just flip. I'll hit for 3 damage. I'll play acrobatic move. Just remove 1 here, deal 2 damage here. Then Nebula hits for 2 damage. Drax will kill off Drang. Okay, that was a really fast game. So my first impression on Gamora's pre-built deck is that it is really good for true solo. It has good ways to remove threat, good ways to deal damage, so you can pace yourself. If you don't hit your attack events, you can just keep the threat in check, and then you can also, if you hit your attack at events, you can just rush down the enemy like we did this game. So Drang didn't stand a chance against Gamora and all of the allies and these events. So I'm really liking Gamora. I think I'm gonna try Gamora with this pre-build against some other galaxy's most wanted villains and see how that goes. But that was my first play of Gamora with the pre-built deck against Krang on standard difficulty. Thanks for watching, and until next time.